Assalamu alaikum. So I recently upgraded my buy price for Dynatrace, and I wanted to show you guys exactly the thinking behind my updated buy price. So Dynatrace is not in any of our portfolios, but it is on the watch list for the PIF growth portfolio. Now, for those who are unfamiliar, Dynatrace is a software company that basically has just one product, and that product is designed to monitor the cloud applications of different companies. And now companies are all moving to the cloud. It monitors the health of these applications and the customer behavior within these applications in order to enable companies to improve their cloud applications, as well as detecting any issues the application may be suffering from and prevent any issues that are forthcoming. Based on the program's forecasts and insights, it does use what it says is artificial intelligence in order to assist it in doing all of this. I've actually spent a good part of this morning learning about their software and the pros and cons of it. And the performance of this company has been stellar in recent years, accomplishing a steady 30% growth rate year over year. And it actually meets the criteria that a lot of private equity and strategic buyers use when evaluating software as a service companies, which is what Dynatrace is. And the criteria I'm referencing is the rule of 40. And basically, the rule of 40 says that the profit margin and growth rate of a company should add up to at least 40 in order for it to be a good buy. And with Dynatrace, if you add the profit margin, which is close to 30%, with the growth rate of close to 30%, you get 60. So based on this rule, it is an outstanding buy. And now, if we use the estimated revenue number in March 30 of 2025 of 1.764 billion, and this number does assume a annual earnings growth of around 30% for the company and around 20% annualized revenue growth for the company, which seems to me to be rather reasonable given its history. The valuation of Dynatrace comes out to the following based on my analysis. Revenue, as we mentioned in March of 2025, of 1.746 billion. This is the annualized revenue at that point, and we assume a 10x revenue multiple valuation for the company, which is what the valuation of this company is right now. So you can see the price to sales for the trailing 12 months is 10.83, and I think this is reasonable for Dynatrace, given its gross margin is close to 85% as per their most recent investor presentation. So, assuming the 10x revenue multiple holds, then we're looking at a $17 billion valuation. And if we want to achieve a 30% return on our investment today, the valuation of the company based on this would have to be around $8.5 billion. Now let's look at how much Dynatrace is valued today. And if we do that, we see it is at $10.41 billion at just over $36 per share. So the share price today would have to be $29.35 for us to achieve the 30% target return today. However, this is assuming that the market is going to price this stock based on a 30% target return. But I don't think the risk profile for this company is such that it would justify the market seeking a 30% return on its investment in this company. I think actually, if you look at the fact that it is cash flow positive and it is profitable and its debt is falling over time and it shouldn't need to raise money anytime soon, then the risk profile for this company seems to be at least average compared to other companies on the S&P 500, and therefore a 10% return is probably what market participants would seek on this particular investment, which would impute a $13 billion valuation, not the $10.41 billion valuation that it currently sports, and therefore the fair price today for this company is right around $46 based on my analysis. Now, today's price, as we saw, is $36. So the upside is basically 30%. Now, if I just want a sanity check to see how my valuation compares with other analysts, and I look at the average price target on Wall Street for this particular company, it's right around $50. So I'm a little below with my price target with 46 and a half. So I do believe that at $36, anything 36 and below, Dynatrace is a buy. And so I updated our watch list to reflect this. And I wanted to make sure I made this video to let you know that I did just that and what my reasoning was behind changing the buy price for Dynatrace. If you enjoyed this video, do let me know by leaving a like or a comment. And until next time, take care of yourself. Assalamu alaikum and peace be upon you all.